Big takes.
Human Fall Flat is a Steam release made in the Unity engine. It's a puzzle adventure game using physics in a different way to normal games. The big question, however, is, as with all games, is it any good? Well, to find out, we have to start with the core mechanics of the game. Even though the game has a single player function, the game is best enjoyed in multiplayer with either 2 or 3, maybe even 4 people. The multiplayer servers can host up to 8 people playing the game, which, well, let's be honest, you really don't need 8 people to play this game. The multiplayer function can sometimes work as intended, but in this instance it really doesn't. Most multiplayer games, when you get into puzzles you really don't want to do, normally end up ending it like this. One of the big core mechanics of Human Fall Flat is its physics engine. For example, simple puzzles like this one require placing a box on a button to open a door. You can see where it's drawing inspiration from games like Portal. However, in Portal, your hand doesn't get stuck behind your head like an idiot. The game is best enjoyed, as I said before, playing with friends. These puzzles, and other elevated puzzles just like it, are tedious to play in single player. Having a couple of friends helping you out playing this game really makes it that much more enjoyable. The level design of this game is strange as well. As you can see there, one of the players doesn't want to do the puzzle, so he's just climbing his way up to the top and going over the wall. This isn't just something that happens in the multiplayer, this can happen in the single player as well. This really needs to be patched if you really want people to play the puzzles. One of the biggest core mechanics of this game is the ability to interact with the environment with your character. You press the right click button and the left click button to grab with both hands, and use your mouse to dictate where you lift something. This is how you traverse the environment and solve most of the puzzles in the game. Getting across ledges and gaps is really strangely similar to the old Tomb Raider games. You run, jump to the ledge, and grab with both hands and lift yourself up. For a big fan of the old games like myself, this is a big nostalgia trip and one of the main reasons I actually kept playing the game. To be honest with you, the game began to get strangely tedious. So now, we have to get to the negatives of the game, of which there are many. If the person you're connecting to has a slow internet connection, the game has severe amounts of button lag, making small and insignificant jumps like this one almost impossible to complete. It begins to make the game so tedious and you really don't want to keep playing with that person anymore. It ruins the aspect of the actual fun the game's trying to give you. Because the game runs on the Unity engine, you get a smooth and consistent frame rate. However, it still doesn't matter. The game in most areas looks bland. The first levels, in fact all the levels except the last one, look especially bland. The lack of textures makes the game look, well, really like an unfinished game. For a Steam game of £12, this really isn't acceptable. Smaller, cheaper games than this have better textures running on the Unity engine as well. This really shouldn't be as expensive as it is. One of the biggest and most grievous complaints that I have with this game is the fact that the character's physics alone are difficult to control. Simply moving the mouse in the wrong direction while standing still is enough to knock you off a small ledge. This can make certain jumps and even entire areas of this game feel tedious. It's one of the big reasons why I couldn't keep playing with only one other person. I needed 3 people to help me complete this game. Where the game's physics shine in some places, they really don't in others. For example, the water physics. The boat feels like it's on the water, but you just go straight through it like it isn't even there. Why your character doesn't have any interaction with the water other than the fact that he drowns when he's in it? Really beyond me. The water level itself is one of the worst parts of the game entirely. The point is to use a rowing boat to get to a speedboat, to get to a large container ship, to ride it into a shipping yard. The problem is, this is a checkpoint system. It's broken here. If your rowing boat gets halfway there but you fall out of it, you have to restart the whole checkpoint. If you fall out of the speedboat on the way to the shipping container, the speedboat remains there, but you start back at the beginning for some reason. The checkpoint system just doesn't work in this game, especially on this level. At this point, you might be thinking that this game is nothing more than a complete piece of shit, but you'd be wrong. Where some aspects of the game fail, other aspects of it really work. For example, look at what the physics can do. As time went on, this game became less about the game itself and more about how you can use the physics to exploit the game. The early levels are almost like a stepping stone, a way to get you suited into the game to make sure that you know what you're doing before you get to one exact point. But when stuff like this can happen, you don't care anymore, you just want to see what else the game can do to make you laugh. And this is where we get to the good points about the game. It's not supposed to be a serious game, it's not supposed to be a display of the physics that the Unity engine can output. It's supposed to be a game to make you laugh. Laugh about what you can make your characters do. So, what is actually good about this game? Well, one particular level. The Aztec level. One of the very few shining aspects of this game. Everything about this level screams nostalgia to me. It reminds me of the old Tomb Raider games I used to know and love. It brings that feeling of adventure back to me. The Aztec level is what you've been working for. It shows you what the game is really about. Textures have been added to walls and you're no longer looking at grey walls, you've got a varied colour scheme. It looks like an Aztec area. Somewhere prehistoric. It feels like an old Tomb Raider game. It works like an old Tomb Raider game. It even looks like one. I keep comparing this game to Tomb Raider because there's really nothing else you can compare it to. Climbing up walls, small ledges, solving puzzles, it's Tomb Raider formula from the PS1 days. It's something that I've missed. The final level shows the amount of polish that should have gone into the actual game. The previous levels mean nothing compared to this. The puzzles are varied, they use physics and weight distribution very well. The mechanics in this level alone sell this game for me. But unfortunately, it's still not worth that £12 price tag for this one level. This level shows what the level designers could do. But for some reason, this is the only level you can't cheese. You can't simply climb over a wall and expect to skip an entire area. The level design here actually works. Why the other levels aren't built like this is beyond me. Lots of puzzles. It seems as though the developers were trying to train the player, get them used to the game the past four levels to get to this one. It's like they were waiting to give you a challenge that still hasn't arrived yet. I hope this game one day gets a level editor, because at least then, there might be a reason to spend the £12 to get this game. End of this level, that's it. The game's over. There's nothing else for you to do. And it's a shame. £12 for a game that could have been really good? I'm surprised it wasn't better. Unfortunately, I don't think anyone can justify the £12 asking price for this game. You can find it cheaper on G2A, yeah, but this is what the devs are charging for it. It's a shame as well. This game could have been worth £12 if the amount of effort put into the Aztec level was put into the others. Still, it should be a good game. If you ever find it cheaper than that, if it's on sale for some relatively low price, it's definitely worth a look. Because of the length and the negatives I've had to list, I can't give this game more than a 5, and I'd love to. It's been the biggest nostalgia trip I've had in years. It really needs some kind of level editor or some kind of workshop on Steam to give it that extra bit of shelf life it needs. It could be a good game, but hopefully the devs will listen. Hopefully they will add a level editor later on. So team, I hope you enjoyed that. That was my first ever video game review. Please give me a like or maybe even comment. Tell me what I need to do to improve these videos.